we continue started the rendering in 3D. For this, I took the plane. I took the first plane, and on this plane, we are going to add the different furniture. And we will add the wall, but we will have the wall in a second part, because here the room is relatively small, so if we add all the wall, it's going after to be complicated to add the furniture. So in this example, first we will add the furniture. Let's start to do this. Let's start, for example, with the room. So I'm going to start with, to close this, I know that the bed is here, so I'm going to delete this element. I'm going to delete this element, and I'm just going to add a guide, this print to 190 centimeter, like this. Then I'm going to go on the 3D wearables. And on 3D wearables, I'm going to type bed. And in this example, I'm going to take for example, I'm going to click on this bed. And after you select download, and you can integrate your component. So I'm going to place the bed at this level, and first things that I'm going to do is to resize. I take scale tool and I'm going to reduce little the bed. Then when you want to place your element every time, I can advise you with the move tool to create and to select a corner, to select an angle, and after to take this angle and to place to the other angle. So you take an angle and you go to another angle. And here, for example, I'm going to go on this angle. And after, I'm just going to have to resize with the different point. So I go on scale tool, and first I'm going to resize at this level. You just need to select the right point, so it means green scale about opposite point. Like this. Then you go here and you select red scale about opposite print, and you can move until the guide like this. Now just I take tape measure tool and I go here, so it looks good. Or maybe I can just create scale tool and could remove little like this. And it's okay for that. Edit, delete guide. Now I'm going to add the two small furniture at this level. So here I take like this. And I'm just going to add my guide, so I know that I would like to have a guide here to 40 centimeter and another to 40 centimeter. I go here and I know that I want to have a guide, so here I tap 40 centimeter. And here also 40 centimeter, like this. Now I go on 3D warehouse again. And for example, I can tap night stand. So I click on nightstand and I would like to add and I add this nightstand. Load this directly into your SketchUp model, yes, like this. So integrate this at this level. After I create a rotation, rotate, I select blue axis, take this point to this point, and I turn, I tap 90 degrees on the angle, like this. Then I take the tool, move tool, I take the imprint. Now first I go here, I go scale tool to change the size like this. And after, I just have to take this angle and I'm going to put at this level, like that. Then I go and scale tool again, and here after I can adjust at your convenience, so here along the guide, like this. And maybe I can improve the size like that. Then I'm going to duplicate this element to have the same thing on the right on the bed. So I go on move tool, I select this angle and I click on control on the keyboard, and you can duplicate. Then you go in the other side of the bed and you can place this also on the endpoint in group, like this. And now for this, it's also okay. Or maybe, yes, maybe you can see here I need to move just this little, so just need to move a little, so I take the move tool, I'm going to move this little, for example, like this. And here you can see, here it's okay, but I'm going to pull and to let a small space also. So I'm going to take this and to create a small space. Like this. So it's okay for that. Now I'm going to add, here I want to add furniture also, two shelves. So I'm going to remove that. Oh, I know that I had a guide here at 20 and then it was 1 meter. So I take my guide tool and here I can add 20 centimeters and also here 1 meter and at this level the same work, 20 centimeters and here 80 centimeters like this. Then I can add a guide here also, for example 40 centimeters, and I can delete my old guide like that. I go 3D warehouse, I tap shelf like this. And for example, I can take something like this. You need to know that you have the possibility to change the color of the component when you import a component. For this, you select your component, you go right click and you select edit component like this. And after, for example, I can choose here on my texture, I can go on wood, I can select, for example, wood, plywood, knots. I can select that and I can go on the plus and to have, for example, this color. To have, for example, yes, this color, and I can edit the component. Now, here it doesn't look okay. It's strange. Because in fact there are two components inside here, so there are two different types of components. So if I select this, it's not the same component, so it's strange. But here if I select this, now I can change and you can edit the color, for example, like this. But after every, this is a different component, so I need to, I can change that like this. Like that. Then after I can go outside and I can edit my component with scale tool and I can change the size uniform scale like this. Then I'm going to create a rotation. So to create a rotation, I'm going to take rotate tool. Or here I forgot to paint. I'm going to come back like this. on the component like that. So I come back here, I create my rotation, rotate tool, I take this angle, blue axis, and I turn 90 degrees. Then I take this point and I'm going to place this element like this. So you need to take this point and to go exactly in the intersection here. Then after, you have just to take your scale tool and to use the central point, so it means this point to reduce, and then it can be this point to reduce exactly like that. After, you can take your tape measure tool and you can see here, for example, I have 0.82, so it looks good. It looks good, or maybe I can increase little the size, but I think it's good. Scale tool, and here also I can improve little like that. Then I duplicate this element, so I take move tool, I select this angle, control on the keyboard, and you duplicate your element. And I'm going to place at the intersection like this, guide like that. After I turn, and it's okay for my two shelves. I continue, here I would like a wardrobe, so I go on 3D warehouse. And I tap wardrobe. And here, for example, in wardrobe, I would like to have, I'm going to take this element. So I can take this and I download in my document. So I'm exactly in the right direction. So for this, it's good. I have just to take the end point, so I'm going to take this point. Our first thing that I'm going to do is just to move that. And then, for example, I'm going to take the guide, so I know that here I'm just in 50 centimeter and 1 meter 70. So I click here like that. I take guide tool and here 50 centimeter, and then I take this point and here 170 centimeter like that. Also, no, it was not from this point. Sorry, it was not from this point. So it's from this point here and 170 centimeter. Take the guide tool, can remove this guide, can remove this guide. And here I can add a guide with, for example, 50 centimeter. Then I just need to place that. So here, just check. Yes, 50 centimeter. I take move tool, I take this angle, and I'm going to place that like that. Then I go here, I go on scale tool, and I select the right point, so this point, like this, and also this print. like that. And for the size, I take my measure tool. Here I have 1.47 meters, so maybe I can improve little the size like that. If I want to have exactly the same color than here, I can take the color picker, I can select this color, and then I can go select the component here, right click, edit component, and I can use this material. Like this. So now it's okay for the color and it's okay for that. Maybe just I forgot this part and it's okay. So we are going to stop for this first part.